y'all to listen, Elder. I want to meet you outside after service. For you, friends. Galatians chapter 5, verse 22 says, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, when people run my patience, thin. That's all I want to talk to you about tonight. When people run my patience, thin. My brothers and sisters in Christ and creation, all of us in church know what it is to have people dance on your nerve. A lot of us know what it is to have people who were called to dance on your nerves. A lot of us in church don't come to church to praise God, but we come to church to make someone's life a living hell. I've learned on this Christian journey that everybody that comes to church is not saved. It don't matter how many letters you have behind or in front of your name. It does not matter how many bars you have on your sleeve. It does not matter how many tongues you can speak. Not everybody in here can handle someone working on your nerves. If we're going to be honest in church, if we're going to be honest in 302 120th Street, there are some people that worked on our nerves on our way here. God have mercy, help me in here. And I've come to understand that there comes a time when you can allow your patience to run thin. Now, preacher, what are you talking about? I know everybody in here saved, but someone was on the verge of cursing someone out. I'm just going to preach it like I feel it. Someone was on the verge of punching or slapping someone in their face. Now, listen, you didn't want to slap them because they stepped on your toe. You didn't want to slap them because they looked at you funny, but they've been getting on your nerves for about 6 to 9 months. They've been working on your spirit for about 10 to 11 months, and you are about tired of dealing with their foolishness. Look at your neighbor and say, are you going to be real with yourself? My brothers and sisters, it comes to my knowledge and it comes to my understanding that it is impossible for you to not want to punch someone in the face. How do you know that? Because the last time I checked, we all fall short of God's glory. But then the Bible says that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Every tongue that rises up against you in judgment shall be condemned. But there are some people who allow their mouths to write a check that their tail cannot cash. Can I preach it like I feel it? A lot of us sitting here are called Facebook's fault. And every time you turn around, folk got something to say. But when they see you in person, God, I feel like preaching here. They ain't got nothing to say to you. And they tell the pastor, so-and-so is getting on my nerves. So-and-so is talking about me. Sometimes you need to check who's coming your way. A lot of us need to understand that some people are called to test your patience.
Yes, sir.
You got to believe that some people are assigned to your patience.
Yes.
Look at your neighbor and say, there is someone assigned to my patience. And your maturity level shows if you're going to allow them to take you out of character. Your maturity is, I know what you're trying to do, devil, but for God I live and for God I die. Because I wasn't always saved all my life. And if you want to take back to the street, I would have laid you out a long time ago. And if somebody in this church would be honest with themselves, I ain't been saved all my life. I might be saved in church, but my mouth ain't saved. You mess with me, I tell you something, and I tell you about yourself. But look at your neighbor and say, it's maturity that keeps you in character.
That keeps you in character.
Understand something as I go to my seat. Understand that it is impossible for you to come to church and not deal with a demon. It's impossible for you to come to church. And let me tell you something. The same ones that dance with you, the same ones that you want to lay out, God, I feel my head coming. The same folk that you want to worship God together is the same one that's pressing your buttons. You got to remember, people study you. People study how you act. People study what get on your nerve so they can get under your skin. People study how you dream. People study. Listen here, we got enemies and we don't even know them. Patience.
Patience. Do you have patience? Did you have patience when they cut you off in the street? Did you have patience when the pastor told you that you are out of order? Did you have Did you have patience when you're getting corrective criticism, but yet you think you're more anointed than the leader? Do you have enough to say, you know what, I'm not going to let you take me there, because if I let you take me there, after service you can meet me down the block and I'll show you what really is going on. I mean, you got to tell them, I ain't been saved all my life. If you really want me to show you who I am, we could take the title off the front of my name and you could just mess with me and we can handle this here, and then we can go back to the church and shout a little together. We can go back to the church and lean out of my a little bit together, but do you really want my patience to run out?
I don't want that.
What happens when you allow your patience to run out?
Yes.
What do you do when your patience runs out? Ask the question, what happens when God's patience runs out? What happens when God is tired of you?
Amen.
What happens when God says, I no longer want to deal with who you are?
Yes.
Then what can you say get to these things? Now, God, I've done everything you said. God says, I don't care. I've warned you about what was going on in your life.
Yes.
I've warned you about everything that you were doing. And now God is saying, my patience has run out. And I come to tell somebody, be mindful of what you do, because secret sin will catch up with you. Why are my Bible study students in here? Let us go on home. Jonathan, let's go. What happens when secret sin comes knocking at your door? And God said, I'm tired of dealing with your sin. I'm tired of dealing with your nasty attitude. You're so anointed in church, but you are nasty at home. Are you the same at home than you are in church? Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, are you still nasty? When God needs you to help somebody, I'm glad you are here tonight, because somebody here needs to know what patience is. Because I still got joy, but I got no patience. I still got peace, but I got no patience. I got love for my brother, with him. You need to get out of God's face if you want God to be patient with you, but you can't be patient with your brother. God, forgive me for my sins, but you can't forgive your brother. God, forgive me for my tone, but you can't forgive your leader. Good evening now, y'all. I got to get out of here, because I'm feeling kind of hungry. But shake your neighbor's hand and shake neighbor. Do you have patience with me? Of the apostle, but thank God that I got patience. It was patience.